Well, thank you all for coming. There are many, many people to thank for today's event. Foremost, His Holiness the 17th Gyalwang Karmapa, who has expressed a desire to address and make a connection with the people of Woodstock. The town officials and town board and all the people of Woodstock, as His Holiness drove up, we saw signs that said welcome home, which was just so heartwarming and so beautiful. And the town officials have been, town board, the police chief, town supervisor, all the employees have been extremely, extremely supportive and friendly, and it really does feel like home. So thank you very much for all of that. As most of you know, His Holiness is a global citizen, but you know, he's also, KTD is his seat in North America, and that means he is a Woodstockian too. Just one tiny little story. I was approached by a teacher this morning who said her students are planting trees on Earth Day. And the children requested that their little trees be brought up here so that they would be close to His Holiness, whose vision for the environment is really changing the world beyond transcending religion. It's really an opportunity for all of us to understand that we share this planet together. We are all one. We're all in this together. And we can learn a great deal from the aspirations and feelings of children. I'd now like to introduce Town Supervisor Jeremy Wilbur, who will introduce His Holiness.
Fellow townsmen, on your behalf, I say to our honored guest, During Derpep, Barkachin She, Jema Yang Yang, Pebrog Nong. We welcome you here today. We hope that you'll come back many times. Ladies and gentlemen,
Woodstock, I do that, me mom, some of it down. Yeah, Tomara, some digital shine.
First of all, I would like to welcome and greet every single person here from the town of Woodstock.
And in Kansu, Gita, Kashre.
This is my third time visiting Woodstock, and you've all extended me an extremely warm welcome and made me feel very much at home. Thank you. This is also my third visit to the United States in general. And on this visit, I visited several universities at each of which I've had to give at least one major lecture, which means that by the time I came here, came home, so to speak, to Woodstock, I was already exhausted. Then I caught a cold. So I come to you today with very little energy. At the same time, meeting with all of you is extremely important to me. So before going on, I want to recognize the tremendous effort that has gone into this and the effort that you've all made to be here today and express my heartfelt appreciation of this.
And the Woodstock needs to be a good thing.
I first heard of the town of Woodstock when I was a child, while I was still living in Tibet, which I left when I was 14. I heard lots of stuff about Woodstock, that it was the land of hippies. And that means something to me, because it means it's a town filled with people who are devoted to personal freedom and environmental activism. Also, if you look at the history of my own particular tradition of Buddhism, most of the great saints within it lived lifestyles that we would call that of a hippie. They lived very close to nature, and they were pretty well all-round natural people in every way. So I think that there is a natural or inherent connection between this tradition and this town.
The living systems and Rando Yana Kandar G Kandar Kurangi Kasuda Jung Takasurada Nubaking or that Nuberjay, that Rigi Sadiore. Just that Digiton and Azuki, the Zuidi, Ranjunkul, the Zuidi Azuda Pergi, some Dondalia. Nurturing
In this 21st century, there is no doubt that the greatest challenge we face is the environmental emergency and climate change. The people of Woodstock have repeatedly demonstrated the courageous spirit of environmental activism that we are all going to have to emulate if we are going to heal our environment. As people of Woodstock seem to know so well already, we must begin to accept that we all depend on one another, that our connection with one another, and especially our connection with the environment, is an interdependent one, and that this environment is not a dead thing made of earth and stones. It is a living system, and we are part of that living system. We are part of the energetic mandala that makes up this planet. In the Tibetan view, the relationship that living species have with the environment they inhabit is one of a container and contents. Our environment supports us, holds us, and nurtures us. In return, however, in that we live in this environment and depend totally for our survival on this environment, we all have the responsibility to nurture this environment back. So what I mean to say is that you, the people of Woodstock, are an inspiring example to all of us. This world is filled with variety, including a variety of spiritual and religious traditions. And in a sense, it is the variety of this world that gives it its unique beauty. Within that variety, of course, there are things we all have in common. In common, we all depend upon the resources of this planet. And in common, we all share a basic desire to be happy, a desire not to suffer. So the fact that our situation is one we all share, one we all have in common, should only be heightened and brought closer to us by the experience of the variety that we embody. I mention this because in this town, there is great tolerance, a great warmth for a variety of spiritual and religious traditions for people of different cultures and national origin. And I want to express my appreciation for that too.
You have said, and that law, but I'm just
I don't want to go on too long, but I do want to thank all of you for the support you've all shown at KTD over the many years of its presence in your town. And I also want to express my heartfelt wish that I be able to meet with all of you soon and repeatedly.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.